It's a cold Sunday to complain. I hold it in until it rain. I fought demons after fame. I spent millions on terrain.
Mexico!
Mexico. If y'all didn't know, we're surprising Ann for his birthday. Lex set it up so me and Kai could come out to Mexico. We in Cancun. And we're going to surprise Ann for his birthday. Happy birthday, though, Ann. Love you to death. How to pop out for twin ass.
I noticed your motherland, feel me? So we can't be in motherland
to show love, feel me? But Kai's scared of
the cartel.
He thinks,
I'm scared, but I'm moving tack, that's it.
You're not. We're going to see how Miki you get in Mexico. I went from no passport to 3 stamps. You got 2, Brokey. Since we started kicking it, you got 2. I got 3. I got Germany, UK, and now Mexico off it.
I got Bahamas, Jamaica.
I don't see none of this shit you talking.
Just vibes. Don't even trip. Yeah, Brokey. Your shit not stamped, broke-ass, bum-ass bitch.
Yo.
Stampy. Look at this stampy.
Two stamps.
You're broke.
I got racially profiled.
Oh, y'all followed in the store?
Yes, that was so weird. I was picking something up like lotion or something. They were following me around and shit. Do I give stealing vibes? Do I give thief vibes?
Let's just say the color of your skin does all the talking. Nigga looked at himself, man.
Ant's gonna walk in. He's gonna be like, ah,
ha, ha, ha. Ask me like this.
Hand to the pocket. No, that's not his vibe. Me been got it.
You gotta be the pocket.
You're crazy.
The little dip got it. Uh-oh. You're crazy.
This whole trip, no Neff and Ant. It's his birthday. Let's let him be on like cloud 9. Ant and Lex are both on 75 party, actually. So they're gonna be on some dialed in, running, 2 workouts a day. And Kai thinks he's gonna join. We're gonna see if this is really gonna join, because I doubt it. You don't wanna like relax. Like you don't wanna relax.
Nigga don't wanna be by himself in Mexico.
You know? I was like, what the?
He said, I told you.
Where is this? Go home.
The motherland.
Can I put this in here or no?
Come on.
Can I put this in there?
Yo, we gotta act like we know Spanish so we don't get finessed.
No. Gracias.
Enjoy.
Brother. Hermano. I gotta say hermano. Gracias, hermano.
Adios.
That's valid? I'm asking Ant like he know. Me and Kai said we gotta like speak Spanish so they don't finesse us. Like act like you know a little bit. Don't be like, huh?
Hey.
Habla no inglés.
How do I say I can't hear you?
No te puedo oír.
Just shut the fuck up.
No te puedo oír. I'm gonna act like I know what I'm saying, but like yeah. I just can't hear you type shit.
You're fucking the air, that's good logic.
Yeah, you would just be like, yeah?
Yeah, that's it.
What?
Just say
yeah.
Hey, hermano!
I spend the money, my man. Give me that. Period. Get you a man who really.
Oh, wait.
Nah.
It's a Yahoo.
Okay.
Strawberry milk. Shout out Mexico, man.
Look,
Ant,
in America, this no, Oreos.
Ant, what do I need? Like, what do I need to get from here to try?
I'm telling you these.
Bet. Snowballs.
75 hard, we literally got to eat everything. You want to eat? Everything you want to eat, let us know. We're going to eat it for you, gang. Yeah.
That is a good crunch. I ain't never seen him sleep that good. Ain't no damn reason you need to be sleeping like that. Oh, he needs his ass kicked. I don't ever want to hear you talk about, oh, you on some fat shit. That is some broke shit.
You
gotta be fucking
big ass. This is fire.
Yeah,
yo,
this was lit.
Damn, Ty, let's get in there.
Aww,
baby.
Yo. Listen, we about to get it on in here for sure.
I said turn the fan on in here.
Nah, I heard get it on in here.
He said, we about to get it on in here for sure.
Did not say that.
Get freaked out, man. Get me out of here. 48.
Get it on. Got it.
We're in a trenchianas.
We're getting pretty deep in the church now. Time to put the camera away for a little bit and
we'll be back.
Focus up, eh? Lock in, buddy.
Is it hot? Yeah, yeah. Yo, he's drunk.
No, fuck, I'm not. That's what he did.
I literally did.
This is hot as fuck. If y'all didn't know, Kai's drunk off the margarita he had. It is a little strong. It's touching you're me, drunk, but you're drunk.
You know a nigga was drunk when he do that. Remember yesterday, what'd you say? You drunk, dude.
Who drunk?
You drunk. Look how you're standing.
Candy.
Oh, shit. That's mustard, I ain't gonna lie.
Peace. I ain't never see this, though. Cookies and cream crunch? I ain't never see that.
What's it done, gang? We're real candy connoisseurs. We have to just scope it out, you see? Just see what's going on in other countries.
Shit like this. The Carlos V? What's this?
I'm about to get that.
That shit look mustard.
Pocket that game.
Yeah, good thief.
Don't steal,
good thief.
Yo, oh, nah. This actually looks OC, be honest.
It's not bad, it's not bad. It's some sweet after you eat.
I ain't gonna lie, I'm trying this. Cookies and cream crunch bar ice cream from Mexico. Not gonna lie.
Oh!
Buster.
Muy bien. Doing sweat.
Bullets.
Hey, yo, it's scary. Kai's not gonna make it much longer.
This is the turkey version, because I don't know what she got. So in case you guys want something in the morning.
It looks like dicks.
We got wieners for us. Oh, breakfast.
Where the candy?
This?
Okay, what's that? What's that? Hey, one by one, break it down.
Like chamoy type of like, I don't know how to explain this, like a tamarindo. But you just kind of like, a little crazy, but you just suck the spoon.
Nah, yeah, I'm with that.
I'm not sucking nothing.
I'm tight shit.
This one though, I want to see you guys eat it.
Okay. Look at you. Savor, you ain't even tasted Big Mac.
What the end?
That's good, I ain't gonna lie.
Owls.
Yo, nah! You want mine? Damn! Laboratory.
We're going to the saloon gym. Kai and I were on a run earlier. I stayed home and just ran and relaxed and stoked up some rays. But now I'm at the gym, about to get painful. So tap in with me on this bicep workout. Let's go.
Big fat ass. I thought he was a ninja warrior.
I can do it.
Cap, give me five.
Five? I can't get a five.
I don't want to see you just do one.
I gotta do one. Up. That's just too hard. Big ass.
I look better than yours. Relax. Shut up. I'll whack your ass. Let's get it in.
She's put him on.
Oh yeah,
This is
new Mayweather.
Hey! Uh-oh. This is broke! What if she just socked your ass? Oh man, chase me with them damn gloves. Back up! God damn. That shit heavy? Yeah, you need that.
Yeah, it's like a little
ass. Come on.
All the way to the top.
Let's do it.
Work for it. Have it.
Let's go.
Come on.
Come on.
Come on. Control on the way down.
You just came to play today. You do not want to work out. Like, what are we talking about? Look at her.
She thinks she's doing something.
This is a buck couple right here. I ain't gonna lie.
We just got back from the Tulum Jungle Gym. Cool little gym vibe. Now we're home, about to shower up and everything. And what are we doing after this dinner?
Oh!
Wait, we're gonna go get lunch and then have a chef pull up because we have the money, we have the most. How you feel about Tulum so far?
It's cool.
Vibey, would you come back?
Probably not.
Not to this area or Mexico, period, or just not to this area?
I would come back to Mexico, though. I find an appreciation for Mexico and, like, the brokenness of it. Well, this area, because it's kind of vibey. The bro shit kind of, like, the trenches is really, like, where I feel safe.
Everywhere is the trenches here.
That's where I feel safe.
You don't feel safe. Stop lying to yourself.
Trench work, boys. Yeah, yeah.
This is really comfy living.
I can do this daily.
Get a cheap villa, hit the corner store, trench work, Tulum gym.
I feel like I would have to be with a Mexican.
You gotta act like you're American. You live here for like 4 years, and they're like, "Are you from America?" You're like, "Yeah, I'm a tourist. I leave Sunday." And you just get all the tourists
ready. Shut your ass up! I need to find true Mexican friends and like just be like, "Yo, pull up to the villa. Let's sniff some coke."
Whoa, what the fuck? Yo, you cut me off to say that dumb shit? Could have kept that one, my boy.
But it's us in another universe, though. Pete. Trio shit. Hard day's work.
That's Kai. Yeah, Kai got a bag, you feel me? I'm in the middle, the little one. Yeah, that's Trimmer.
Chef cooking up. Mashed potatoes, guac, corn. What's in there?
Veggies.
Veggies?
I'm gonna put there that chicken.
Baked chicken.
Tortillas, got mashed potatoes, got a steak.
That's not tortillas.
That's tortillas.
We have tortillas.
Chicken, the chicken look busted. Look at your thigh. Look at your
thigh. We got eats. Look at the views.
What's going on, Pain fam? So this is what, the second day now in Tulum. I think Ann and Lex just went on a run. I think it's just me and Kai here. I haven't left my room. I just finished getting ready and everything. Lex is surprising Ant with massages. They're supposed to be here in like 30 minutes or whatnot. So gonna go get massages. I think they're coming here. I don't know if they're gonna do it in the rooms or they're gonna bring tables. I don't know what the setup's gonna be. Last night you seen we had the chef come and she went in and cooked up for us and everything. The food was actually terrible. I'm not even gonna cap. I'm glad we had eight. Before that, we had like two burritos, me and Kai, and Ant went out to go eat. And I'm so glad we did that because the chef came and cooked some bullshit. The mashed potatoes was ass, some fat, greasy, nasty shit. The steak, bro, I was chewing the steak for dumbass long and I couldn't even swallow. I spit it out of the napkin. It was not good at all. But it is what it is. I guess it was just a vibe and experience having somebody come. And she smoked out the whole goddamn living area out there. My eyes was burning and shit. We had to open the door, bro. It was crazy. Today is massages. I'm excited for that. And I think we're gonna try to go to the gym after that. And I would like to go to the beach today. It's a little gloomy today. It's not gonna be really sunny at all. It's like overcast, but I would still like to go to the beach either today or tomorrow. And I think we got the big dinner as well for Aunt tonight at some nice ass restaurant. So I'll definitely bring y'all for that so y'all can see what that's hitting on. Massage shit, happy ending shit, hopefully shit.
He was trying to bust that down, big boy. He was trying to steal. You can't take him out the hood, bro. You really a thief ass dude, man. Back to your old ways. Bro, I had to tell him to stop stealing out of Walmart, you know that?
That's crazy. What are you talking about?
Bro, I didn't convince you and Nazi stop stealing out of Walmart.
We just self-checkout. First of all, I was broke. I had to pay bills. You was living with your aunt.
I still convince you to stop stealing. Like, no matter how broke I am, I'm stealing. Not gonna steal.
Yeah, it was self-checkout shit. Like, just skip a few
You're
things.
You're stealing!
That's not stealing.
You're literally stealing. Like, what are we talking about, Nigel? So what is it?
Couponing.
Stole.
Like, what was like the biggest thing that you ever stole?
Like steaks. Like $20 steaks, like for the fridge.
He was really stealing.
And we were like hit different Walmarts to like not get too high. That Kroger, remember that post that story? Them people were fighting outside of Kroger. Yeah. We stole so much shit because they were like a good distraction. Oh, and we racked up like four chickens for the free.
Oh, no. I know that feeling of like stealing, walking out of Walmart is just bad.
Nah, not really. That shit buzz. I ain't gonna lie. That shit hit different. When you pay for everything in Walmart, you be like, I didn't finesse, like it's L trip.
You do something like your skill points go up. Uh-huh. Like that's how you feel when you steal, huh?
Like my stealing points is really high. Nah, yeah, I did rack them up.
Man, your stealing points is definitely up there. What is going on here?
Flex.
Hold on, un momento.
Flex. There's like a whole family downstairs.
I think they're trying to kick us out, Lex. I think they're trying to kick us out. Like it's a bunch of people down there.
There's a whole family outside.
I think we gotta get checked out and they're checking in. Imagine.
That was crazy. I don't know.
He's pissed. He's so mad. He's like, open the door.
Like, there's a whole Mexican ass family.
They have like luggage and shit.
Why are you just.
Hello. No, yeah, you gotta handle this.
Hola. ¿Cómo están? Get in. We need banda.
Wait, no, wait, no.
Wait.
Oh. Wait, what are they doing? Why are you letting them in?
Like, why are you letting him in though? Yeah, like, yeah.
Good surprise massages, buddy.
That is a great surprise.
W surprise on Lex once again.
What was he thinking they were coming from?
I was like, yo, wait, like, did we get like double booked? Thought it was like a double bookage type situation.
Massage time.
I caught a right one. Heen POV. Strip. Go ahead.
Bro, don't try to put me like.
What? It's weird. A massage.
Weird. Why make everything so weird?
Get up. Get up, bro.
Get on. Bati. Get on. Get on. He was talking shit. Go.
Don't do me like this, bro. All right, fuck it. Me and my man, yo. Yeah.
Hit it at.
It's not Compy Raids. Lex sold, bruh. I'm with some future plan. He's on my boonda. That's Bati. Yo. Oh, shit. Nah, that shit's OC. Yeah, you straight twin. You gotta keep it thuggy. He whispered in my ear, you good? That's it. Keep it playing, son.
He was bulging when
he
got to your leg.
Hey, yo.
Your
body. What?
He was bulging.
Why, because he was?
Nah, my beef don't get hard unless it's my girl.
Okay, buddy.
Why are you looking at my beef for one and for two I was not bulging?
Oh, your body.
Eggland.
The section. Ann's about to drink on 75 hard.
Ooh. Ann.
Ann, look at him.
They get crazy.
Freaking. He need all the tahini. All of it.
He get real nutty.
Yo, when he's done with his drink, the tahini is gone. No cap. Right, the rim is gone.
It is. That is true.
Yeah.
Here. Do it like this. Don't be selfish. You gotta break bread, that's your man. You want my water? Give you a swig. You can't get a swig.
Why he running away? Give it to him, gay.
Hey, boys, for me. You got the bezos for him.
I ain't got my wallet, twin. You gotta bust that down with him,
you
twin.
Share with him.
He's stressed out, twin. He's stressed out.
I know, man. I feel
get,
bad.
Get it from Gangi.
I might have some coins, though, gang.
Difference, bro.
You a hustling dude. Oh, I got coke face over here.
Oh, yeah, get right. Nah. Be grateful, gang. You gotta be grateful. Come on, Gangi.
Don't do that. I don't got no more, Gangi. Come on, dude. You ain't even give me no toys. All right, come on, dog.
Yo.
I rocked out with y'all. Come on, P.
Nah,
you OD now, gang. You OD. You OD.
Hey, you better watch that down with your twin, man. Don't do that. Don't do that.
You OD, fam. We on my man.
Nah, for real. I ain't got nothing, cuzzy. Hey!
Dinner at that place was pretty fire, can't lie. The vibes was good, the music was good. After dinner, we ended up just coming back to the crib. Overall, Tulum's been a good experience. Like, we are in the trenches, like, we're in a nice villa, but we are in the trenches. So, like, I think it's good to kind of, like, some trips go resort, some trips, like, get the authentic country feel. And I think that's what we're doing this trip. But next trip, I need the resort vibes because, But the people here in Mexico, they're not giving me no hard time or nothing like that. They're not really tripping on shit for real. It's just crazy how in America we be taking like advantage of like the freedom. Like we dead ass got freedoms that you really don't realize like in other countries you go to. Like there's shit you just cannot do here that in America you're just granted the freedom. And overall, the way people just live out here is like trench living. Like worse than trenches, like American trenches. Like you just think about it. Like even what I do for a living, like influencing, my own clothing brand. Somebody in Mexico, like a little kid in Mexico who lives in these slums and these little shacks out here in Tulum. Now, they're not even granted the freedom or the like liberty to goddamn dream or have the thought to create a brand or the resources to do some shit like that. Or even like have time. Like, think about any Mexican influencers that you know that's probably out here and popping in Mexico type shit. Like, I wouldn't think it's that crazy as it is in America just because a lot of these folks don't have time to be sitting up on social media and YouTube every day watching influencers and shit like that. So it's just not a market for them. So it's just like, in America, there's a lot, and it's starting to make sense, like the perspective I'm getting from traveling and things like that. It's starting to make sense, like, what is actually good about the U.S. in a sense, you know what I'm saying? Like, everybody like to shit on America and things like that. But it is, when you put it in perspective and just travel a little bit and see some old shit, it just be like, damn, like, a lot of shit we take for granted. You know, folks ain't even granted that access, that liberty to goddamn live the way that we live in America, you know what I'm saying? Granted, we got our own shit to deal with in America, but, you know, shit ain't perfect everywhere else. That's all I'm saying. And I asked the guys what they think the benefits of traveling are, and we all kind of agreed that it's just really perspective and gaining appreciation for a different culture, obviously, like, gaining appreciation for Mexican culture, and then, obviously, appreciating the shit that we got in America a lot more as well. Like, just perspective overall, just being more worldly. And a lot of people who are intelligent, rich, obviously travel and things like that. So just being able to like relate to people who are probably of importance to you, just on a trip of traveling and shit like that. A lot of conversations that I've had when I first got into like talking to people with money has always been about traveling, and I didn't really have too much experience and whatnot. So we gonna keep stamping on this passport. This y'all sign to go travel if y'all haven't yet. Sometimes get the authentic feel, go live in them trenches with these folks and really, you know what I'm saying, see what the culture has to offer. Sometimes you resort up and don't even got to worry about some shit and it really just be a nice, beautiful, aesthetic-ass trip. But hope y'all are enjoying the video. I'm about to shower, call it a night. It's been a long day. See y'all last tomorrow.
You want to go for
some fun? I'm with you at home.
If I go away, you coming with me, buddy.
You go at home.
You going back? Why you touching me? I'm not touching you.
You
want to
go at
home? Why you touching me?
I'm
not touching you. Why you touching me? I'm not touching you. Why you touching me? Yeah, brush it in the pool. I want you to brush your teeth in the pool. Don't touch me. I want you to brush your teeth in the pool. Go get some water for the go get some water for the pool, bro.
You know what's something? Knowing some shit's not good when I don't eat it.
Whatever, but not that.
You just gotta order the right shit. That's all it comes down to. Just order the right shit.
You got L taste buds, you know
it. Don't eat that. Don't eat that. It's nasty. The food's rotten. Oh, bad smoothie bowl spot. Yo, that shit got my stomach hurting already.
I don't got none, gang.
Oh, amigo.
I don't got no more pesos. I gave it to freaking
your cousin.
On the car? Yes, my mom on the car.
See? No car, brother. Sorry, bro. You supposed to have a peso. It sounds just like a little kid running up to you. Bracelet?
Nah, he's mad.
That's
cute,
what I'm
though.
Saying. Like, I just need to give you peso.
You got the he ran up to you because he was like, he's a black American. You could have like proved his fantasy, right? By giving him bread and be like, damn, bro. Black Americans are lit. They always got money for me. Now?
So it's my fault I don't got no peso.
Okay. You supposed to have peso. In America, you say you be having money for the homeless. Supposed to be out here with money for the,
You in their country, might as well get back. You trying to hurt my feelings.
Oh, I'm not. You're the bully. You don't know how to neff, Lex. Your neff is literally to cut deep. I think it's a woman thing.
Like they hold it in and they just kill you.
Yeah, like it's just like. That's why you don't want to tell girls nothing, bro. Because they use shit to weaponize it against you. Right, Ant?
I really haven't experienced that.
Yo, nah. You're crazy. You're in 4K, buddy.
Oh, yeah.
He's just literally the next Messi.
Ronaldo's better than Messi. Bro.
Messi's better than Ronaldo, dickhead.
Ronaldo's better than Messi.
What team does Ronaldo play for?
Huh?
What team does Ronaldo
Portugal.
Play for?
Portugal.
You're witnessing the future right now.
I know.
It's the Mexican Michael Jordan.
Which one? Which one do you think is like the best? Like, which one do you think is going to come out the best?
Yellow, white, and blue?
Nah.
He's him. He's going to be the best goalie in the nation.
That one right there? He's not going to be the best. Nah. I was going to say he's not going to be the best. Because he's too drippy.
Yeah.
You gotta look at the one that's being most coachable. Like whoever's being most coachable, whichever one the most serious. Like look at that grown ass man up there with the blue green shirt. Dale, come on.
Oh yeah.
Diga. Oh yeah. They hooping. Oh yeah, give me this. We
yo. Imagine we in New Britain at Chesley hooping. Somebody's outside just camping out. Like, which one of these need to get saved? and they saved you, your life will be different.
You'll be in the league right now. Yeah, the G League.
A lot of dudes run in the rain. A lot of dudes just
stay fresh. Yeah, I got it all too, man. Mark Jacobs, Balenciaga, Balenciaga, CPFM, yeah.
Feel like David Goggins out there running in the rain. I come to you on live. On live, showing your face.
That's work. While you out there running for your self-pleasure, I'm working, nigga. That's the difference. Chat, talk to me, tell me something, chat. Yeah, Balenciaga, Balenciaga, CPFM, you know.
They the ones on 75 hard, not you, gangy.
I felt like I was in that rain, I ain't gonna lie.
Let's go get it, bro. I'm trying to see.
You ain't trying to get it.
I'm trying to see that shit hit.
I'm telling you, it's different out there.
Nah, that would be vibey.
It's different out there. Rain coming down, headphones on.
I be thinking about the goddamn sidewalks be so broke. All them water puddles. Was you stepping in them?
I did it. I felt like I was like right here. It's all right here. It was all right here.
You don't even run at home though.
Huh? Yeah, cause that was like, oh, like that's like, that's top tier run right there.
Why?
It just like, it, you don't understand the feeling. I can't explain it. You just gotta feel it.
Let go run. Come on. Wait, I don't got it. I'm trying to run. Hey, in the rain, no chat. Be honest. I don't know. Y'all might miss me on that one. Running in the rain, ducking a cartel. That's a lot going on.
And just like that, the trip is over. I hope you enjoyed the video. Spam, happy birthday, Ant, in the comments. It's been my best friend for a little over a year now. I don't know, the bond we just built over this short period of time has just been so real. And he just fits in with the gang and everything. So shout out my brother, BBA, man. Happy birthday, my brother. I love you to death. We're going back home to Dallas now. Got a 2-hour drive back to Cancun to the airport. And then a 2-hour flight back to Dallas. More videos coming your way. Trying to be as consistent as we can in 2024. I really enjoy pumping out these videos for y'all. And yeah, it's been real Mexico. It's been real pain, fam. Love y'all to death. And we out.
Don't do me like this.